Benny Bowright threw down the exclamation point last night. It was not the easiest win, but the Trojans moved to 2-0, the number 10 ranked team in the country. I am Jordan Moore alongside John Jackson and Benny Bowright. It's the Chevy closeout, and the 2017s are going fast. Find special closeout pricing on many of Chevy's most popular 2017 models like Silverado, Tahoe, and Traverse. Visit your Southern California dealer or SoCalChevy.com today. Benny, what's up, man? You went for 28 last night, a career high. And I think what's interesting about it, we know you could score, and you've sort of been around that number a bunch in your career, but you didn't make it only 1-3. How has your game changed that you're able to get, you know, a number like that without having to do it all from the outside?
Right. Coach Jason Hart preaches to me every day that I'm not just a jump shooter, I'm not just a three-point shooter. So when we work out, we work on a variety of different shots, and it paid off.
You know, talk about your game last night. I mean, you guys end up winning and beating North Dakota State, and you know,
JJ was nervous.
The expectations are going up for you guys, as you know, right? It's no longer okay to have mediocre performances. Everybody's going to expect you to blow everybody out. How about the expectations for you guys? Obviously you guys are shooting to get to the Final Four and all those types of things, but you know, as a player and sort of short term and long term, how good can this team be?
We understand we can be really good. We just got to take it one day at a time. That's our mentality. Just every day, just improving practice.
Your off season is one thing I wanted to get to, Benny. You changed your body a little bit. We always talk about guys changing their body. Usually they're trying to bulk up. It looks like you made a conscious effort maybe to slim down, get a little lighter. What was your goal in the off season to make yourself physically in the best shape for this campaign?
Just overall, get my body stronger. Last year I was hurt all last year, so this year was I wanted to come in healthy and be more agile and ready to go.
You guys have a lot of returning starters, and it's a veteran group in terms of there's guys that have played together. It's not a veteran group in terms of your guys' overall age. There's a lot of youthful players on the team. But knowing that you're coming back with guys that you played with last year, a lot of guys that have been in the starting lineup, how familiar was it last night, you just getting back into form, or is it a different year and it's sort of the same thing as maybe last year, try to knock out some of the kinks early?
It's pretty similar. We're all pretty much comfortable with each other. We all know what each other wants to do on the court. So, there's only a couple guys that are new, but for the most part, it's the same.
You know, we never really talked about your backstory at all. And last night, you talked about how you're in love with the basketball.
Yeah.
You have a relationship with the basketball. Were you that kid that just always had it like a yo-yo on your hand growing up? When did you fall in love with the game?
Yeah, it started at a young age. You know, I was always had in elementary school, always had my ball wherever I went. I used to sleep with it, just roll over and do follow-throughs at night. Just always held the ball in my hand.
Is that how you become a great shooter? I mean, I got my little son in the house. He's 3 years old. How's he become a Benny Bowright and shooter like you do? Because, you know, even at your size, it's such a natural stroke for you.
Right. Just work on it every day. Just make sure you keep your touch. And you can always get better at shooting, so.
I'm not going to let you off the hook. I'm going to go back to the game last night. It's tied at halftime, right?
And we're down 10 with 2.5 minutes to go in the first half.
Yeah,
it was
exactly.
Good it was tied at halftime.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you guys, you know, were able to tie it at halftime. But, you know, you guys go into halftime, and, of course, this is a team, you know, you're expected to beat. What was the temperament at halftime? I mean, was it tense or was it relaxed? I mean, take us inside the locker room a little bit.
We've been through it. We've been through it before. You know, they used to call us the comeback kid.
right.
So we still got that in us, and we just kept our composure, knowing that we can come back any time because we're explosive offensively, and it's just a matter of getting stops.
Speaking of comebacks, why'd you come back for your junior season? Obviously, you know, you're a guy whose skill set will definitely, you know, lead you to make some money playing this game. Why'd you come back for another year at USC?
Just to get stronger and win a national championship. Win a national championship, that's our goal. We understand that we gotta take it one day at a time. And Coach Martin Bahar said – Cause he said a line yesterday that was very resonating to us, that was that we got to worry about now, and later we'll get to where we want to go.
You know, and with a team like this, where you know a lot of guys were, several guys were in your situation where they could have left, but they decided to come back. You know, how much was it talked about amongst you guys as a group to come back, because this could be a special year if everybody returns, which they did.
We all made our own decisions. You know, we don't want to pressure one another, but but I'm glad it all worked out.
I heard a story, though, about how you told your teammates. I guess you got, like, a group text about workouts, and then, you know, somebody said, who wants to work out? What, and you jumped on there, and they said, what's that mean?
Yeah. That's how it went. Yeah, they all started posting pictures, getting excited. I'm like, calm down, man.
Now, if there is one thing, I mean, last year, of course, your greatest stroke in threes. You only had one last night. I mean, that's not a big deal. But if there's one thing about your game that you – that's better this year than it was in 2016, what is it?
Defensively. Okay. Defensively, I like to now I can want to get low and defend guards instead of standing straight up, try to block a couple shots, and get out in transition.
Six blocks through two games. Let's say you're off to a good start, you know, yeah. Certainly in that regard. Let's talk about important things here. Benny, you made a major left turn with your hair in the middle of the season last year. You have such a great quaff going on up there. I mean, are you planning on throwing a curveball again this season, or are we going to stick with what we know works?
No, I'm going to switch it up.
You are going to switch it up.
I got to keep everybody on balance.
So is this like a big game thing? You know, you're going to wait for conference play, UCLA or something like that? You know, how's it work? How do you make those important decisions?
See, I can't let y'all know this.
Oh, this is all a secret. More secretive than the victory bell. They won't tell us where it is, and you won't tell us how you make decisions about your hair.
Yeah.
And you have to compete with J-Mac as far as hairstyles go. So is there internal competition amongst you guys in terms of how the hair looks and what's going
to
happen?
Yeah, guys try to get waves every day. Yeah, I mean, everybody knows I got the best hair.
Okay.
Well, Ronald Jones just walked in the building. What about the dreadlocks? You think you could rock the dreadlocks?
I can't rock the dreadlocks like him, but we both number 25, so
there
we both
represent.
That's true. 25 is the number right now at USC. You guys all go to the football games? I see you guys out there. You guys have fun at the football games?
Oh, most definitely. Definitely.
Yeah, and what about this team as a whole? I mean, the camaraderie obviously is going well. How much do you guys hang out off the court? I mean, I know that you have to hang out on the court, but how much do you hang out as a team off the court?
All day. Okay. All day. We all just hanging out, playing video games, talking mess. It's fun.
So what would it mean to you, Benny? I mean, you set that championship goal. You know, this is sort of a place that doesn't necessarily have a big-time basketball history. What would it mean to all you guys, the core four that have really built this thing, if you could leave some kind of legacy here, have a banner that hangs forever?
Oh, it would mean a lot, you know, especially with guys that we all love each other and we want each other to succeed. So.
All right. Well, we are counting down to kickoff, also counting down to tip-off. Benny's back in action on Sunday. You're going all the way to Nashville. You ever been to Nashville before?
No.
You like country music?
Nah.
Me neither. But you're going to hear plenty of it if you want to down in Nashville. You're taking on Vanderbilt, big-time game, Pac-12 SEC battle. It'll be 5 o'clock here and it'll be on the SEC Network channel, hopefully many of you have. And they'll tip off on Sunday, like I said. And we're counting down to kickoff with Mito, Swiss watches since 1918, the official timekeeper of USC Athletics. Be the first to own the Fight On limited edition timepiece. True Trojan fans, visit shopmito.com/USC. That's shopmito.com/USC. Like I said, we're going from 25 to 25. Ronald Jones is in the house. Questions for Rojo next on Trojans Live.